My gas furnace kicks on then shuts off. What do I do now?
If it has turned on and off a couple times and goes into a lockout mode, you have to turn the furnace off and back on to be able to restart it again.
That only starts the next round.
Check the air filter. If it can't breathe, it won't run.
The filter is cleaner than anything else in the basement.
The furnace will verify the pressure switch, limit switch and rollout switch are all closed before turning on the igniter on a gas furnace. If any of them are stuck in the wrong position, the furnace won't do anything past turning on the inducer.
I could try to flip those switches back manually.
For things like the limit switch and pressure switch, the furnace will try to start up again in a few minutes. For a rollout switch, though, it won't restart due to safety concerns.
Yeah, a gas furnace doing its job too well.
For most furnaces, the inducer motor starts up before it ignites and the blower motor engages once the air is hot enough to distribute.
Yes, that's what gets air to the furnace and then distributes the hot air to the rest of the house.
If the inducer doesn't turn on, the furnace shuts down before it even ignites. If the blower doesn't come on, the furnace shuts off.
The furnace makes way too much noise for me to think that's the reason.
If the blower motor is not going fast enough, like 250 RPM, the furnace may not run because it isn't moving enough air.
That's enough air to move the hot air to the rest of the house.
If the furnace is overheating quickly, it will shut down too.
It is hard to imagine the furnace overheating. It is supposed to get hot.
A gas valve that puts out too much gas that puffs up in a cloud of fire will do that. And so can a furnace that gets really hot but can't cool off as hot air is distributed.
Now we're back to lack of air.
If the inducer turns on but the gas valve doesn't close fast enough, the furnace shuts down to prevent a fire.
And if it didn't open at all, it wouldn't do more than run the inducer for a while.
You'll also get a furnace turning on and back off if the flame isn't seen.
I can see it.
If the flame sensor is too dirty to sense the flame or broken, the furnace doesn't know what you do. If the thermocouple is too far from the flame, it doesn't recognize the flame.
Those are the easiest things to clean and replace in the furnace. Any other cause cleans me out.